स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम ईशान त्रिवेदी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. वेलकम यू इन द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ बिल्डिंग प्लानिंग. टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड इन दिस सेशंस आर एलिगेंस, इकोनॉमिक, प्रैक्टिकल कंसिडरेशन एंड सैनिटेशन एज अ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ बिल्डिंग प्लानिंग एंड द सेपरेट थ्योरी ऑफ orientation of a building is being discussed. So let us start with elegance. It is the grand architectural appearance of a building because of grand elevation, which in turn depends on very good plan. So to have a good elegance, we require a good plan so that we can enhance the beauty of building by its outer appearance and we can achieve elegance. Selection of a site for a building greatly affects its elegance. A beautiful building located in a depression or in downfall may go unnoticed, whereas an ordinary building on an elevated spot gives impressive appearance and catch attention of everyone. Like in hilly region, there is not any hi-fi building or any heavy feature has been done for the beautification of a building, though it seems like beautiful because of its location and its surroundings. A better elegance can be achieved by selecting superior building material for facing, such as polished stone of granite, marble or mosaic, glass, either transparent or opaque, colored or plain, timber can be polished teak, wood, paints and varnishes with proper contrast. By providing projection like sunshade, balconies, canopies, porch, with or without pergola opening, this is how you can achieve the elegance. Here in these images, you can see the porch. Porch is the extended portion of any building while approaching towards a building. It can be cantilever or it can be column supported. Here the wooden timber member has been shown. These timber planks are placed horizontally and vertically, which forms a grid. This grid is nothing but a pergola opening. So the porch can be with or without pergola opening. Even in roof terrace, you can see number of steel planks has been provided to get appearance of a building. That is also called pergola opening. Elegance can be achieved by providing bay window, corner window and etc. This phenomenon also has been taught in prospect. By providing kink in wall to accommodate window and cupboard instead of straight wall. Aesthetic, utility and maintenance are to be considered while planning an elevation. So this is how the elegance or beautification of a building can be done. Next building planning component is economy. I'll start economy with one question. How will you achieve economy? By compromising strength and stability of a building, or by adopting poor quality of material or poor workmanship in a building construction? No, we cannot compromise the strength and stability and the material and the workmanship, which compromise the lifespan of a building. So the building should have minimum floor area with maximum utility. It will reduce the cost of construction and hence there will be economy in construction. Economy should not be achieved at cost of strength, otherwise the useful life of building get reduced. Economy can be achieved by implementing few measures without affecting the utility and the strength of a structure. These measures are of providing simple elevation, disbanding of porch, lobbies and balconies, reducing the story height. Even you can reduce the number of steps of a stair by giving more rise to the steps. By standardization of size of various components and material. So this is how you can achieve economy in construction and while planning of building. Next principle of building planning is practical consideration. Above all these principles of building planning, practical consideration are of those consideration which kept in mind while planning of a residential building for future consideration. While planning a building, the first consideration is the strength and stability of structure inclusive with convenience and comfort of the occupants. The building has to be designed in a such a way that you must not have to compromise the strength and stability as well as convenience and comfort of inmates. In future, if the owner wishes to add a wing or extend some part of the house, the provision of this should be made while planning the building. For example, I wish to construct only ground floor. In future, if I need, I will provide a first floor. But at present, I want to construct only ground floor. For that, what I am doing, I will construct ground floor and provide a slab. While doing slab work, I will extend some reinforcement beyond the column size so that in future, if I want to add one more story, I will take reference of that column and I will tie those reinforcement with new reinforcement and make another column or additional column so that I can construct second floor or second story. Then elements of the building must be strong and capable of withstanding the adverse effect of environmental factors that are likely to arise. Like we face the problem like earthquake, tsunami, high tides or high winds which damage the property. So it has to be designed in a such a way that it can face the environmental problems. As far as possible, the size of room should be kept large. The large room can be shortened by providing movable partitions, but the smaller room cannot be enlarged. The life period of the building should be at least 50 years. The money should not be spent unnecessarily to elaborate architectural purpose like balconies, arches, porch and cornices. We can use prefabricated elements for lintels, sunshades and steps. If all the bedrooms are planned in the first floor, at least we have to provide one bedroom in the ground floor for sick and old. The number of doors and windows should be minimum from the safety and strength point of view. So this is how the practical consideration is being considered while planning of a building. Next is sanitation. Sanitation can be achieved by providing proper light, ventilation, cleanliness, water supply, and sanitary amenities. For residential building, the window area should not be less than 1/10 of total floor area. Whereas for school building, it should not be less than 1/5 of total floor area. Here, the ventilation means the supply of outside air in the building. This can be also understood by an air change. This phenomenon will be taught in upcoming sessions. It is achieved by proper positioning of doors, windows, and ventilators. The sanitary units should be provided with non-absorbent flooring material with proper slopes, dado on walls, continuous water supply, and proper ventilation. The provision of various components of a house is made in a such a way that it keeps the inmates cheerful and free from diseases. So these are the principles of building planning. I'm ending this theory here. and starting another theory, that is of orientation of a building. While planning a building, the first consideration is the orientation of building. This orientation of a building can be achieved by considering various phenomena. But first of all, we need to understand the site. The site can be of our choice or we have to accept as it is available. Orientation of a building is the proper placement of building and its components such as various rooms with respect to natural weathering elements to get the maximum benefits of nature's gift. Because of the neighborhood of the site, the layout of road, of street and other factors, a building has to be oriented to face a particular direction. In India, being a tropical country, the best orientation is the direction of prevailing wind. The natural agencies like sun and wind are utilized to get best advantage by proper orientation of a building. As I said, there are certain factors which are influencing the orientation of building that we need to understand. These factors are temperature, wind, and humidity. These factors are interrelated with each other and these are depend upon such as sun's path throughout the years and its relative position with respect to locality. The sun path is different in different region and that we have to understand. Second is direction of prevailing wind, particularly in summer. In any city, there is wind rose diagram and wind diagram which is helpful to understand the prevailing wind condition throughout the year and particularly in the summer. And the next is the character of rain and its intensity. Different region has different intensity of rainfall. So these are the parameters which we need to consider. At the same time, as I said, while determining the location of a residential unit, we need to understand the sun path and the prevailing wind condition. In country like India, there are two different sun path. One is from January to June that we call Uttarayan, and the second is from July to December that we call Dakshinayan. So from July onwards to December or to mid January, the sun path is from east to south to west, whereas from mid January to 22nd of June, the sun path is from east to north to west. So particularly in summer time, the wall facing from east, north and west are hidden up. So the longer wall of the building should be placed towards north and south, and the shorter wall should be placed towards east and west. So here in east side and in west side, the wall should be kept shorter, and based on our movement, we can orient the building so that we can avoid the hidden up of that particular area. So in east direction and in west direction, the wall will be of shorter, whereas in south and in north direction, the wall will be of longer wall so that it will be lesser hidden up. So these are the basic fundamentals of orientation of building that we need to consider while planning of a building. So I am ending this session here. I hope you have learned about orientation and the principle of building planning. These two elements together will give you the brief idea of how we can locate or how we can orient an individual room or building room component so that one can have the maximum advantage of natural phenomenon. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you have learned something from this. Thank you.